Everyone, we have been listening to climate change, global warming, etc., and many other very, very important topics. And happy to be listening to everything. Now, in fact, I'm going to take you all on a small cruise on Indian research ship, virtually. I mean, there are different types of vessels. We say cargo ships. That's we can call them merchant ships, defense vessels, etc., etc. So, what is a research ship? How it is different from other ships? I mean, with respect to the structural designs and other aspects, it's all the same. But especially for a research ship, there are some complex design features that have to be met. So that we will very, very briefly I go through it, and then since the time is very short, I'll just briefly go through it. See, one, a research vessel is designed, modified and equipped to meet the scientific requirements. So there are huge number of scientific requirements, and they have to be incorporated, most of it has to be incorporated into a small ship or a medium ship or a big ship. With respect to MOS, Ministry of Earth Science, having five vessels, I'm from NIOT, we are managing three ships and two vessels are being built. One, the bigger vessel is Sagar Nidhi, which is a state-of-art ship, and it's an ice class ship, it's a DP class 2 vessel, and etc., etc. And of course, we have a medium vessel, that is a medium-sized vessel, Sagar Manjusha, and the Sagar Purvi. Sagar Manjusha and Sagar Purvi are basically used for the coastal research, that is within EEZ. So these are the general specifications. I'll just skip through. This is actually flagship of NIOT, and we are able to do a lot of activities. This ship has been to Antarctica waters up to 66 degrees south, almost, I mean, five times. So I have a small video clipping. I don't know if it comes. Yes, okay, I'll skip that. These are the features and inside compartments of the ship, the integrated beach management, and it's a DP, dynamic positioning two vessel, and a very high-tech vessel. Even after 12 years of construction of this vessel, we still consider this vessel as one of the most sophisticated ships, especially in Asia. And some of the research ship, this has a drop keel facility wherein we can install some of the transducers for scientific measurements, especially for acoustic measurements. This is very, very effective. And we are actually having two small vessels being built in India at Calcutta, of Sagar Tara and Sagar Anveshika. These are 45 meter vessels, and these are going to be used for research work within EEZ. So the link is missing, so I can't show the one of our vessels is launched recently in the month of December. But now that link is missing, I can't show that video. Okay, now I'll just come back to the various problems in managing research ships in India. Whatever I'm talking, it's with regards to the constraints within India. See, we have so many issues. The research vessels, we don't have a separate category or classing in the Ministry of Shipping. They are classed under MS Act with a clause of special purpose vessels. So there are some problems. And other aspects like, you know, entry, we don't have our infrastructure because number of research vessels is less, and we don't have the similar ships. Since the numbers are less, we don't have our own berthing facilities, we don't have our layout jetties, and we don't have our, you know, facilities like the like other ships, like, you know, for different ships, all these things are not there. Okay, I'm not comparing different ships, just I'm trying to bring out a difference. So what happens is, if a scientific mission has to start from a particular port anywhere in India, at least the process of immigration clearances, port clearances, and there are empty number of clearances that will take a huge number of days. At least, for example, if I talk of Chennai, it will take at least 3 to 4 days time for every crew. That means in a year, at least, there is a loss of about 35 to 45 days time only on this. Though we may do some other parallel activities during this time. But this is a practical problem which is very difficult to solve, though there are efforts to solve it. But the problem here is, there are rules, there are set procedures, we need to follow it. So what are the efforts to overcome this problem? This is a set procedure, so we can't do it. So there is a loss of time. How we can sort of compensate this time so that time can be used for the scientific activities or for some scientific expeditions? Because every day is a huge costing for the ship time is a huge cost. So what is the best solution? With our experience and with the past experience, and we have a small team of people, we have been discussing on this, and we arrived at two key solutions. One is inventory control, a proper inventory control, and second is innovative engineering solutions. Because any maintenance work that is taking a lot of time, even if it's a small thing, because the process are same, because it has to be verified by a third party, and there's a huge checkoff list that requires a lot of effort, a lot of time. So wherein lot of time is being wasted. For example, Sagar Nidhi, if you take, in a year maximum we can operate this vessel for 300 days. That's the maximum. Though it's very good, it's a phenomenal effort compared to other research ships in all over the world. All over the world it's about 270 to 280, but we are able to operate this vessel for 300 days. But still, with our experience, we feel that another 20 to 30 days we can easily compensate by way of a proper inventory control and innovative solutions. How? I'll just show you how. So especially on the inventory control, though preventive maintenance and all that is there, so when a ship has a breakdown or something like that, we need to have the critical spares on board ship. So how it can happen? So by the history of this breakdown, history of the ship, so we have arrived at a particular pattern and then accordingly started stocking up these spares. So in the last 5 years, I will, in terms of statistics, I'll give you an example. In the last 5 years, Sagar Nidhi has had about cruises of about 70 cruises in the last 5 years. And the delay, because for want of spares, is only 2 times.
2 minutes.
So, yes, I'm just finishing. So some of the solutions, what we have arrived is, like, you know, for example, 10 years back, when we had one of our ships as an underwater hull damage, so which required a dry docking, but we found a solution to do it at harbor by with some engineering solution, by designing a watertight chamber and incorporating there and then doing the welding. That was a huge success, and this procedure is adopted by international classification societies, and this also gave us good confidence with respect to developing some innovative solutions. And similarly, we have clad welding of propeller shafts of the ships. These propeller shafts are costing a huge money, and the delivery time was almost about 6 to 8 months time from different parts of the world. Then we developed a procedure called clad welding that has helped in the cost, and the time to repair is just about 2 to 3 weeks time. This was another success. So these are the processes that are in the, and again, the dynamic positioning, what was happening is, when the ship was in dynamic positioning and when some scientific activity was going on, the system used to trip. So we found out the problem, and we designed a proper solution which helped. Now in the last 4 years, there was only once the DP system failed. So like this, we have made like A-frame repairs. A-frame was costing about 2 crores. We made some one concept which was implemented on these airframe ramps, and it helped us cost reduction and the time. So likewise, there are so many, especially in the gearbox, especially in small vessels, what happens is the gearbox response time was very high. So when the ropes and all that were getting entangled into the propeller. So we developed, everybody said gearbox to be renewed and all that stuff. But then after a detailed study, we found a simple engineering solution was given, and at a cost of just 20,000 rupees, and the ship is running fine for the last 4 years. So even the fuel filters we were importing for $400 per filter. Now same thing, with the same performance we developed in India, it is costing about 350 rupees. So likewise, we have done so many solutions. This way what has happened is, we have reduced the cost, we have reduced the time for the repairs, and thereby increasing the efficiency of the ship, thereby increasing the operational time of the ships. I think, there are many like this, and we are implementing on the ships, that is helping. So to be effectively managing the ship, I think these two are the key areas. One is inventory management, and second is developing innovative solutions that will help. And on the green technology also, we have developed a model for reduction of the NOx and SOx, which probably I don't have time to elaborate. So if you can see this slide, the kind of time saving and kind of money saving on various solutions that we developed. So this way, a management of ships can be very, very effective. Thank you.